Hi guys, good evening. We are going to be presenting a new Instagram session, which is with young designers who have fresh thoughts and are adapting to change. We are just waiting for Ms. Priyanka Arjun to join our session. Hi, good to see you guys. I guess Ms. Priyanka has joined. Just waiting for Ms. Priyanka to join the session, so hopefully we'll get started then. Hi, Ms. Priyanka. How are you?
Yeah, good, good. Hello.
Hi, nice to see you, and welcome.
Yes, thank you.
And good evening, folks. We are excited to present our new Instagram series with young designers. It's about fresh thoughts and adapting to change. We are privileged to have Ms. Priyanka Arjun, founder of Priyanka Arjun Associates, Udaipur. We request you to follow us on Instagram on Priyanka Arjun and Millennium Marbles to keep receiving our updates. We want you to feel inspired at the end of the session so that, you know, you guys have learned something from it. So about Ms. Priyanka, she is an architect based out of Udaipur, where she leads the design firm Priyanka Arjun and Associates, PAA. She graduated from in 2006 from ASA, Jaipur, and established PAA in 2013. Is that right?
2000. Did I get it correct? I graduated 2006.
Six. And 2013 was your establishment, right?
The founding of Priyanka Arjun Associates.
That's right. And she's done hotels, top-notch luxury apartments, resorts, hospitals, and restaurants. Is that correct? I'm guessing so. Hopefully, right.
Yes.
And as for me, I am Saurabh Agarwal, proud owner of Millennium Marbles. We have two factories in Silvassa and Shulagiri, where we are doing, about 300-odd stones from 15 countries, marbles, onyx, travertine, and granite. And we also have an app on iOS and Android. You can just type in Millennium Marbles, and, you know, it's a virtual factory at your fingertips. So, yeah. So, Ms. Priyanka, with further ado, I welcome you. Thank you for agreeing to do this session with us. It means a lot. My first question to you, since you are North India's one of leading architects and interior designers, what are your insights on design and architecture post the pandemic, and what kind of impact do you see on the industry, ma'am?
People have become more aware. So, okay. Some people say that if we just talk in terms of business, the business has increased manifold. For architects like us who are into creating recreational spaces also, because now people got like 3 to 6 months of spare time to think on what they actually wanted to do. So that's now right. Many projects pouring in where people want to create spaces that actually matter. People are more focused on residential design also, because now they want their homes to be open. They want sunlight to flow in. The holistic element has seeped in. It's not just a space to, you know, have a rudimentary house. Ab sabko usme hawa bhi chahiye, roshni bhi chahiye, immunity bhi strong hona chahiye. So the things have changed, the perspective has changed. And I think, of course, COVID has been devastating for many, many people. But yet, it is also it's just passing through the fire, and many people have learned a lot from it, which is great.
That is true. And keeping in mind, as your, what do you think of Priyanka Arjun stands for in one sentence or two sentences, and how, what can people learn from it?
Yeah, the motto has always been the same, that we are designers, we are a design practice. So as we say, it's also on the website and everywhere, that design according to time, place, and people, but always strive for timelessness. So if you make something today, please do not regret it 50 years later.
Yeah. Sustainability is what you're talking about. I think that's what PA is for.
And creating spaces. So it has to be designed. That comes out with thoughtful design, it would come out great.
Okay.
Yeah.
So just a note to the followers, don't forget to follow us on Priyanka Arjun and Millennium Marbles, you know, for future exclusive content. Stick around. Don't leave yet. Because keep watching this live for more exciting information and some cool takeaways, yeah? So, as I noticed, I was browsing and reading about you and, you know, I got to know that stone, lime, and bricks are a recurring theme or, that you know, elements that you use in your design. So, can you give the audience, the budding architects who are watching, and ideas or tips to contemporize old materials into, you know, modern designs?
So I am from Udaipur. From childhood, I knew about stone and lime buildings, but my actual now, if you talk about the future, I think what we at Priyanka Arjun Associates are doing is we are taking the history further, which is we know about stone buildings, we know about brick buildings, and if I talk about it, our generation is more about technology, about using technology as a strength. So
right.
If one example, stone buildings are discarded because they take lots of the stone as a material takes space which is rarely available in residential sector and all. So we have devised a new system of making composite walls. So we are having a RCC shell, which is having an envelope of the stone wall. It is not stone cladding. So you are again having a 6-inch stone wall on the outside, made with a brick wall from the inside. So the brick wall from the inside takes care of your electrical and your services. The stone wall protects you. And making these kind of houses, you may say, but I'm really proud that my clients don't have to use AC in the summers in Rajasthan. And nice, when I went to a house in winters, I went for like half hour. But I stayed there for 7 hours without a sweater. So it was a... these are experiments. It doesn't, because nobody has done it, but we do small experiments and then we elaborate them. So that is what an architectural practice is about. You keep practicing and you keep evolving.
No, but your clients are safe that way, right? Because you said you keep practicing, they're happy. Nonetheless, that, you know, Priyanka has done a good job.
We make them aware in the beginning.
Okay.
That
risk they have that comes to give
So everything is clear, and then only, of course, I'm not going to con them into it.
No, definitely not. That's not the idea behind the people. You're absolutely right. So, I want you to give the audience a glimpse into your process, which means, you play with scale, you play with spaces. And I think some of it you might have mentioned, but how do you go about creating your spaces? Like if it's a blank space, how do you visualize, or what do you, you know, give us a glimpse into your process, if thought process or planning.
If I say design or thought process, first it starts with, first thing is that you decide that you are not going to repeat yourself, number one. Then, of course, one input comes from, we do competitions and design for clients. So, the input comes either from client or from, so it's a client brief that brings you ki kya banana hai. And on the client brief, we write our design brief in forms of words. So, there's some tangibility to finally what you're going to make, the words that are going to weigh your design process. So, we write those on the paper, and throughout the designing, while we start sketching, there are many people in the office. So even if two or three architects are working on the project, everybody else is there to criticize, to add their ideas, or to discuss on the same. So For example, if I do sketching, I sit with three other people and I ask, tell me what is wrong, tell me what more can we do, and then how that's how the process goes beyond. So there are stages from sketching, then making it into a layout, then development, then adding the construction techniques, then finding that there are things that you cannot do. Then it's a practice, basically. So we have some logical steps and some illogical ones. They make the all weirdness and the quirkiness that comes out. It comes from there.
That's right.
Yeah.
So we're keeping that, the quirkiness in mind. How do you blend decor elements, as you said, such as metal and steel, with stone elements and marble, in fact, maybe also?
I think we should talk about stones, as you into the discussion, you have more knowledge of stones because you are firsthand working with stone, and yeah, you did it 365 days. We as architects, I have worked a lot with stones, be in masonry, be in finishes, be in furniture. And initially when I started working with stone, I had no clue. It was simple ki, if it is pink, it is good. So if you could give like 1, 2, 3 steps, that whenever a designer comes looking for a stone or goes anywhere, हमें क्या ध्यान रखना चाहिए? That for the matter, now I know in Indian marbles also, these small spots that we call makhi, जहाँ पर marble weak होता है. पहले मुझे नहीं पता था. So if it is something like this, you could share, that would also be great.
देखिए, basically ऐसे for the upcoming people, I mean anybody that are watching, so सबसे पहले तो आपको अपने मेरे हिसाब से अगर मार्बल सेलेक्ट कर रहे हैं, आप मेरी फैक्ट्री आ रहे हैं, तो आपको ये पता होना चाहिए कि मैं क्या लगाना चाहता हूँ, कि मेरे का इंटीरियर क्या है. आर्किटेक्ट से या इंटीरियर से बात करें, आप लगाना क्या चाहते हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल व्हाइट बेज, साउथ में व्हाइट और बेज सबसे पॉपुलर है, तो अलग टाइप के कस्टमर होते हैं. एक तो आते हैं, बोले हमें ही पता है, सौरभ आई नो दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट, दिस इज व्हाट यू सजेस्ट, और हम उनको बताते हैं कि हाँ यू नो यू गो फॉर अ व्हाइट, यू गो फॉर बेज, वी शो देम अराउंड. And they are very budget conscious. They are very, as you said, cracks nahi hone chahiye. There should be fissures. There's a fine understanding people that can confuse fissure hota hai, jaise body pe scratch ho gaya. You know, like a normal scratch on the body. And then you have your crack, which is through and through wear and tear of the marble. It's a major difference. So fissure cover karne ke liye, we have machines, resin machines, jo apne usko cover karti hai. Then it creates a resin sheet on the marble. जो बाद में आप पॉलिशिंग में यूज करते हैं, बिकॉज इट्स हेल्प विद द फ्रिक्शन एंड ऑल दैट, वो होता है. तो आपका बजट है, कलर है, थिकनेस है, और आपको यू नो व्हाट एरिया यू वांट टू लुक एट इट, फिनिशिंग क्या चाहिए, उस हिसाब से आपको कोई भी आए तो चूज करना चाहिए. दैट्स द मेन आइडिया. एंड व्हाट बेसिक मटेरियल इज सजेस्टेड बाय यू, सजेस्टेड बाय द अदर आर्किटेक्ट्स, तो ब्लेंड कैसा है, हाउ डू यू वांट टू क्रिएट विद योर ओन माइंड, एंड वैसे होना चाहिए. आई थिंक आपका आपसे बात हो रही थी, मेरा इंटरव्यू चल रहा
है. या बट नाउ आई थिंक स्पेशली विद द एडवांसमेंट ऑफ सीएनसी टेक्नोलॉजी, वन थिंग आई फील हैज प्रमोटेड स्टोन फ्रॉम बीइंग अ फ्लैट सरफेस टू अ डायनामिक सरफेस. लाइक अब हम बहुत ज्यादा वॉल पे स्टोन लगा सकते हैं विथ 3D CNC. वी कैन गिव ग्रूव्स, वी कैन गिव मोल्डिंग्स, विच एक्चुअली शोज हाउ द ग्रेन्स एंड लाइन्स ऑफ स्टोन्स आर मूविंग थ्रू आउट द स्टोन, एंड दैट एनहांसेस द ब्यूटी अ लॉट. अर्लियर इट वॉज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू एंश्योर दैट काइंड ऑफ डिटेल इन एवरी प्रोजेक्ट. ऑफकोर्स इफ यू हैव टाइम एंड now one can design easily without having any constraint of time or money, especially with stone and metal, as you said. All these things can be easily added into each other. We have so many good things which can put them together. You just don't need the age old joinery system also.
Oh, and the
multiple venues have opened with the machines, and give so much liberty to create more. Yep.
And also, I would suggest Ecosy मुझे बोली finally just to close this point. As you said, marble कोई लेने आता है, anybody comes by flooring, they want for the wall, but it are also the decor elements, marble elements in your home, your
Yes.
table, your pot, or anything of that sort. You can start using in a smaller way possible, just to get a feel for royalty, just to get a feel for old world charm, you know, evergreen.
Go for there are great wash basins that, and then you could see the whole lines going through and the water falling on them. It is a very good thing
pleasing
to
to the
do.
eye, pleasing to the eye,
Yes.
Shanti. Pleasing. So my
And,
next question will be, sorry, go ahead. You said something.
With stone, one also gets an assurance that there is something which cannot be damaged easily.
Yeah, that cannot be damaged. That's very,
Yes.
that's
Strength
very
is a little bit.
relaxed
Yeah.
about it.
Yes, and it's
So
going to
next
be
thing,
unique throughout.
Unique, definitely. It is unique. And each slab is unique, as they say. It's nature,
Yes,
you
the
know.
biggest thing.
Now, biggest thing. So, in keeping that the uniqueness in mind, and how do you say, aapke liye, is it aesthetics over structure, or do you value structure over aesthetics? Right. It's a fine line, but you know, you can help me out here, help the audience a little bit.
I would say both, but they both have different roles. So aesthetics has a different role, that things has to be pleasing to eye and mind, body, soul, everything, but structure should be there to keep the things intact. So
that's not there, that's fine.
A structure can be beautiful, but they can be independent of each other, aesthetics and structure at the same time. So yeah.
We have a question here. How does sandstone work on the outer walls, as we have seen in Rajasthan palatial buildings?
So when one sees sandstone in Rajasthan palatial buildings, it's all the old buildings that are there, they are made in raw sandstone, which are actually big solid blocks of stone. So that is complete stone masonry. Nowadays, when people work with stone to make it cost effective, stone cladding is done. And
okay.
For that, you need a 19 mm to 25 mm thickness of sandstone, which is usually put through either adhesive or dry cladding on buildings. With sandstone, there is one. It could be a boon or worse because it is porous. So, if the water quality in your area is not good, the sandstone will have watermarks over it. So, people do sealant over the sandstone, and that just kills the beauty because it makes it plastic. So that is a basic awareness thing. But if you use sandstone, use it as it is. Let the stone age. When the stone ages, it brings that grace in the building, that it changes over time. So that is the that is one of the greatest strength of using stone, that you are creating something which is going to live.
That's what I tell people. They're worried about, you're welcome. But that's what we tell people about when ghar pe they worried, you know, marble lagate hain, then they worried polishing kaise hoga, it will come off. I mean, listen, it's not too much. It's about you, nature, you know, it's like, it's not a living thing, but it's got some life in it. It's natural.
Yeah.
So what do you mean? I mean, if it ages, kuch gir jata hai, kuch hota hai, toh let it go on. You know, it's not a problem.
It's a process. Virtually. It's your
it's
end
a process.
The store
exactly.
intervention. That is what
exactly.
Yeah.
So we also just came to know, I got a ping that you are conducting the Udaipur Architectural Festival in December. Is that right? Congratulations.
Thank you.
Can you please tell us more about it and what will be showcased?
Sure, I would love to talk about it, sure. So Udaipur Architectural Festival is happening on 16th and 17th of December, which is very near. And I am part of the back-end team. And we are bringing in great speakers from around the world. And it is not just that they are going to just display their works and talk about them. It is going to be an interactive session on topics like sustainability, on collaborative practices, on workshops like origami. There are going to be liver discs who are like great cartoonists. So it's the celebration of architecture for 2 days, which is going to happen on a virtual platform. Yeah, so it's Udaipur Architecture Festival. One thing I would want everybody to attend is please attend the talks, and there is also competitions and unbuilt works that are going to be there. So if one gets time, go through the website, and if there is anything, I'm there. So any query?
You can always ping her at Priyanka Arjun, you know, and then when you guys Google, you're smart enough to Google Udaipur Architecture Festival, you get to know Priyanka about it. So.
Yep.
So, guys, we are at the end. One more question. Do you suggest to put stones on outer walls in common small home if they can afford? I guess, yes.
Yes. Yes, always, because stone is a better insulating material than the normal brick wall that we have. And slowly the climatic effect of what we used to have 50 years back and now is different. So if you give another skin to your home and you put it wisely in the directions where it is required, and you could have it in budget, at the same time it is going to protect and enhance the beauty also.
Okay. So guys, we are at the end of our session, but before we go, we'd like to take up any questions you may have. You can also, if you can't think about stuff right now, you can DM them to Priyanka Arjun or Millennium Marbles. I will send your questions to her. I'm not going to be able to answer those questions, because anything about stone, as she rightly advertised for me, that I can talk a little bit better, but yes, she can definitely do anything better. So follow us for your notifications and turn on for any helpful content. I think we'll just wait for a few moments, if you know, just to see if anybody liked our talk and they want to ask some questions, of which we cleared any doubts, hopefully. Any more questions? I don't think so.
Yeah.
No more questions, guys. Well, I guess we end the session. Thank you, everyone, for joining in. And Ms. Priyanka, thank you so much for taking the time. I know you're super busy. You're very busy with the festival and your personal work and, your projects. With your knowledge and expertise, I'm sure everyone watching here has something particular to take back home and important tools which they can, better get into the design aspects. If you guys need a special consultation with Priyanka, you can follow her on Instagram. Please message her on Priyanka Arjun. And she will definitely get back to you as soon as possible. So if there's anything you want, if you, and thank you once again, and do enjoy your week, everybody. Thank you so much. Bye. Bye-bye. Take care, guys.
Bye. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.